Hi, this is Dr. K. Anbukarasi. I'm going to discuss about the design of gearbox now. In order to obtain different cutting speeds from a single machine tool, a special device will be attached in between the prime mover and the spindle. This device is known as a gearbox, which contains a number of gears arranged in a specific format, and by adjusting the position of some gears with respect to others, we may get a different speeds. The another important application of gearbox is an automobile, where low speed is required at starting and stopping, and high speed is required during the running. This could be achieved by using the gearbox. In gearbox, there are different types of gears are used to make a design box. Here, actually, for example, spur gear, where the teeth parallel to the axis used as a sliding gearboxes. In case of helical gear, teeth inclined to the axis to form a helix, whereas in the double helical gears, two sets of opposing helical teeth are available for the transmission of or getting the different speeds. In epicyclic or the planetary, spur or helical gears rotating about the center, which are not satisfactory. In the gear ratio or the velocity ratio between a pair of gear wheels is inverse ratio to the number of teeth on each. We already discussed in the design of gear, that is spur gear, helical gear. In all the cases, the speed ratio of the N1 by N2 is equal to D2 by D1, that is the diameter of the wheel by the diameter of the pinion, that is equal to the number of teeth on the wheel divided by number of teeth on the gear. Likewise, here NB is the driver member, NA is the driven member. So, driven speed by the driver speed is equal to driver diameter by driven diameter. Here, this shows, that is NB by NA is equal to DA by DB, that is the inverse ratio of the number of teeth on each should be is equal to the speed ratio or the velocity ratio. In the case of power, speed and torque, the power will be calculated. The power which be transmitted is directly proportional to the speed of the revolution and torque acting on it. Since the power is proportional to PNT divided by 60, so for a given power, the torque is inversely proportional to the speed of the revolution, and if the revolution unit is reduced, the torque will be increases in the same ratio. That is, TB by TA is equal to NB by NA. So TA is nothing but the torque transmitted by AA, and TB is torque transmitted by gear B. This shows the kinematic arrangement of the gearbox. Actually, in the gearbox is containing many gears of different number of teeth arranged in a different shaft, which may be a solid shaft or splined shaft. In solid shaft, the gears are fitted in such a way that they can rotate only and cannot move in the axial directions, and also some gap is provided in between the two gears. Whereas in the splined shaft, two or three gears which are already meshed together like this, meshed together and act as a single unit, are fitted on the splined shaft in such a way that it can rotate and also move in the axial directions. By means of a lever, we can change the position of the meshed gear and make them to engage with the other fixed gear, so that we can obtain the different speed as possible. From this diagram, if the gears 1, 3, 5 are fitted on the solid shaft A, and gear 4, 2, 4, 6, which are meshed together and acting as a single unit and fitted on the splined shaft B. So, when the gear 2 and 6, and the gears 2 and 6 are also rotating idler, when the shaft B is rotating at the of what we are getting when gear 3 and 4 is meshed together. So by this arrangement, the different speeds can be obtained by engaging the gear when gear 1 engaged with 2, we get a one speed. Suppose by using the lever, we change the position when the like such as gear 3 is meshed with the gear 4, we can get another speed. Again, we changed the position, meshing or contacting position of the gears by using the levers. If the gear 5 and 6 is meshed together, again the speed will be getting varied. Here for example, if the solid shaft is the prime mover, which is rotating at a constant speed, the splined shaft is a spindle shaft, which require many number of speed. Here we used only a 3 speed, so we can able to get only 3 different speed by using 2 shaft. So if the solid shaft is rotating at a constant speed, when a gear, that is a smaller gear, is meshed with the gear, that is a larger gear, means the speed is automatically reduced from, which is A shaft is rotating at 1000, means now B is rotating at 400 only, due to the smaller gear is meshed with the longer gear. Similarly, if smaller gear on the solid shaft is 5 only, if gear 5 meshed with gear 6, means the speed will be a little bit only reduced compared with the 3 and 4. So likewise, we can able to get different 3 different speed from a single motor shaft by using the gearbox. This is the geometry progression ratio or step ratio. That means the different speed can be obtained from by using the gearbox. This can be decided what are the speeds. This can be divided by employing a constant known as a progression ratio. For example, if there is a phi different speed, we know that pi is equal to n2 by n1. That is the speed, that is the ratio of the one speed to the next lower speed. I mean, here pi is equal to speed n2 by the next lower speed n1. Similarly, n3 divided by n2. So if there is a phi speed, means the n5 by n1 equal to n5 by n4, n4 by n3, n3 by n2 into n2 by n1. Here there are pi 1, 2, 3, 4. Similarly, we have a 4 phi, that is pi power 4. Actually, here 5 different speed. So we can rewrite as pi power 5 minus 1. So the general formula is derived from this: n maximum by n minimum equal to nr, that is r number of different speed, that is the last maximum speed of the driver, by the minimum speed of the driver. So nr by n1, that is equal to pi power r minus 1. If the number of speed is 12, means n12 by n1, that is equal to pi power 12 minus 1. From this step ratio or the progression ratio, pi is equal to n maximum by n minimum whole power 1 by r minus 1. Based on the design of gearbox, the designing process is designed based on some principles. The first one is to avoid extensively large diameter of the wheel, and also to limit the principal line pitch line velocity of the gear. So the main thing is, these are the two conditions: to avoid the large diameter and also to limit the pitch line velocity. This should be, the following should be adopted. The first one is the number of gears on the last shaft, that is the spindle shaft, should be the minimum. Then second condition, the number of gears on the shaft not be more than 3. In some exception cases, it may be 4. Then the third condition is, if it is possible to have n maximum is greater than n input, is this greater than n minimum? That is, the maximum attained speed should be greater than the input speed of the drive. Then the input speed of the drive should be the greater than the minimum required speed. So suppose this is the, for the two shaft here, for the stages here, this is minimum speed, then this is the maximum speed. The selected input speed, it should be lie such that it should be closer to the n maximum, or it should be admitted. It should not be closer to the n minimum. If it is closer to the n minimum, means that is the that is not safer design. Okay, so based on this conditions, the n maximum by n input should be less than or equal to 2. Similarly, n the ratio of n minimum to n input should be greater than 1/4. So while designing the gearbox, we should remember all these three factors in order to get a maximum power transmissions and also in a number of speed up. In framing the structural formula, here the number of speeds is 12. We can write the 12 in the multiples of, that is 1 into 2, 1 into 2 into 3 into 2. That means we require actually our number of spindle speed from a single motor speed. Actually, practically it is not possible. So, the now maximum number of speeds that can be obtained from any two shaft is only 3. Because the maximum gears to be meshed together may be 3, that we already discussed. Hence, if the number of speed is more than 3, we should employ some intermittent shaft between the motor shaft and spindle shaft. Okay, so here this is the one is representing the first one, second one, third and fourth one. So this is the first shaft, second shaft, third shaft and fourth shaft. So generally here we need four shaft. The first and last shaft is the first one is the main shaft, last one is the spindle shaft. Then in between these two is called intermittent shaft. So these intermittent shaft are need to get more number of aid so that the required number of speeds may be obtained in the multiples of 2 and 3, so that the 12 can be rewrite as 1 by 2 by 3 by 2. So we can rearrange in such a way that is 2 of 1, then 3, the multiplication of this comes here, so 3 of 2, then here it's again 2, then the multiple of this comes again here, so 2 of 6. So in this stage we can frame the structural formula for the design of gearbox. So 2 of 1 is the first stage, 3 of 2 is the second stage, and 2 of 6 is the third stage. For example, in third stage, so in third stage here the 2 means outside of the bracket, the 2 is 2 different speed. The 6 within the bracket, 6, there is a 6. This means there is a steps in between the 2 speeds. Okay, so 6 means 6 steps or 6 intermittent gap between the 2 speeds. For example, here the last stage 2 of 6, here the ray 1, that is the 1 speed, here another ray, that is the second speed. When the intermittent gap between the two, these two speed are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Actually, it comes here. Okay. So, like this, we can arrange a structural formula and draw the kinematic or a ray diagram. For example, if R is equal to 6. Here, R is equal to 6 means 6 different speed. So, we should write in terms of multiples of 3 and 12. 3 and 2. So 1 by 3 by 2. Why we are putting 2 in the last? As per the rules, the minimum number of gear should be placed at the last shaft. So we can write 1 by 3 by 2. Then we can rewrite as 3 of 1 and 2 multiple of 3 and 1 is 3. So in the first stage 3 of 1, in the second stage 2 of 3. Here let us take in the second stage, we always started from the last stage to the first stage. So here the last stage is the second stage. So here how many shafts we need? Actually 1, 2 and 3. So from the kinematic diagram, we can identify number of shaft we need, or from the multiples of 3 and 2 also we can identify the number of shaft required for the six spades or any number of spades. So from in when consider the stage 2, here there are two different spades.